What is going on YouTube? Welcome back to the channel, and in today's video, I'm going to show you how to set up your Touch ID on your MacBook Pro. Stay tuned. All right, guys, now that we're over here at the computer, let's jump into it. It's a very simple process, and what you're going to want to do first is go up to the top left-hand corner and click on the little Apple logo. And then you're gonna want to come on down to System Preferences. Now, I'm sure there's different ways to get to this by searching Touch ID in the Finder. This is the easiest method that I found, plus I like to go in and take a look at all the different types of security settings we have in here. It's gonna go through, it may check for updates, but I'm gonna go ahead and skip that and then just click on the little grid of squares up here, and that's gonna bring up all of the System Preferences on the actual Mac itself. And then you're gonna want to go down to where it says Touch ID and click on Touch ID. And it's going to load the Touch ID settings. You can see Touch ID lets you use your fingerprint to unlock your Mac and make purchases with Apple Pay, iTunes, and the App Store. So as you can see, I've already got a fingerprint in here. Say you wanted to add another fingerprint for such as like a relative or a family member or your spouse or something, you can add their fingerprint and allow them to unlock the computer. You can also choose what they can unlock with. You can use unlocking your Mac, Apple Pay, iTunes, and App Store. So it allows you to kind of customize what you want to use the fingerprint scanner or the Touch ID scanner for. So what we're gonna do is let's go ahead and click on add a fingerprint. And it's gonna walk us through the steps on how to go through and add that fingerprint. And you can see right here, it says place your finger, lift and rest your finger on the Touch ID repeatedly. So what you're gonna do is you're going to take your finger and you're gonna lift and then rest it and kind of move it around so it can actually get a nice image of your actual fingerprint to allow you to unlock and use the Touch ID. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna use just a different finger here. Like I said, you wanna kind of lift and rest just until it says, okay, you're good. So it says, keep going to capture the edges of your fingerprint. So again, kind of rotate your finger around and just get a nice full image. There you go. So once you're done, it says your fingerprint can be used to unlock your Mac. So you can go ahead and click done. Now with Mac or with Apple, if you reboot the machine, you do have to type in your password for the first time to unlock it. If you then, from that point forward, if you just close the lid, reopen it, or it goes to sleep, you can then use your fingerprint scanner to unlock the Mac. Another cool feature that you can do with the Touch ID is you can go in and rename each fingerprint to identify whose it is in case you have to remove access later on. So what you do is just click on the fingerprint that you want, click on the name of it. It'll then give you an edit box. So we'll call this one Aaron. And then on the finger two, we're going to name this one David, and then we'll click out of it, and that'll confirm the names on there. Now, say you have to go in and you need to remove a fingerprint because they no longer need access to this machine. What you do is you just hover over the fingerprint, left click or click on the X. It's going to give you, are you sure you want to permanently delete the fingerprint? Go ahead and click on delete, and that will remove the access or remove their access from this machine. Hey everyone, thank you so much for spending some time with me today. If you liked the video, give it a like. Just a quick question of the day before you go. Do you or do you not like the Apple Touch ID? Leave your answer in the comment section below the video. And of course, while you're down there, don't forget to hit the subscribe and the bell icon to get future notifications. And we will see you in the next one.